Hey everybody, this is Philip. Hope you're doing well, blessed. Welcome to another episode of the 3-Minute Build. You know, one of the things y'all heard me say over and over again is, as leaders in the kingdom and in God's churches, we gotta make decisions with the next generation in mind, not just with our comfort zone in mind. Well, I wanna be a little bit more specific on what I'm talking about when I say those things. So, hey, let's jump into it. Let's get going. The clock is ticking. Today's build is called 80%. Here we go. Are we losing teams to the world? Is the church connecting with them in a way that earns their attention? The statistic is 80% of the people that are born again accept Jesus Christ into their heart before the age of 18. If we do not win young people to Jesus, when are we going to win them? The odds are not good after 18, are they? Teenagers are desperate to find a kingdom leader who will believe in them, spend time with them, be proud of them. They may never voice that need, but your influence makes a difference. They need the wisdom you have gained in life to navigate the world. All right, I got some things on my heart. Rant, no holds barred, let it rip, potato chip. How do we make that happen? Here's how it begins. We got to know what teenagers want and what they don't want. Let me first tell you what they don't want. It's three words. You ready? It's sit down, shut up, and listen. That's not what they want. But those words kind of define a young person's life. They go to school. What do they get? Sit down, shut up, and listen. They go home, sit down, shut up, and listen. They go to church, sit down, shut up, and listen. Children's church, youth group, Sunday morning, sit down, shut up, and listen. They're tired of sit down and shut up and listen. They don't want to do all three. Let me tell you what they want. They want some ownership. They want some skin in the game. They want to be a part of things. They don't want to be a spectator. They want to be a participator. They want up on that stage. They want to sing. They want to play those instruments. They want to preach. They want to ask questions. They want somebody to ask them questions because they care. They want some conversation. They want some dialogue. They're tired of sit down, shut up, and listen. My kids, they it's been years since they've wanted to camp. They never wanted to camp. They wanted to intern. They wanted that staff shirt. They wanted to be part of some things. Why can't we have teenagers out there in the lobby greeting? Come on, who would they be greeting? Other teenagers. Why can't we have children with the name badges on out there greeting? Who would they be greeting? Other children. We've got to get them involved. And if we'll make this happen, they'll develop a knowing in them that it's not just their parents' God, it's their God. It's not just their parents' Jesus, it's their Jesus. And it's not just their parents' church, it's their church. And if that happens, they're going to transition from youth group to church. And they're going to stay involved in the kingdom all the days of their life. That's what we want, but it's not going to happen by accident. It's going to happen by knowing what they want and knowing what they don't want. Hey, think about these things. Ponder them. Let's make it happen. Let's make some decisions with the next generation in mind. Hey, God bless you. Talk to you next time.
Hey, guys, this is Philip. Hope you enjoyed this episode of the 3-Minute Build. For more, make sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Just search PBM Philip Baker. And if you're wondering, what am I reading from in the build? Well, it's our book, The Build, which is available now at philipbaker.org. 203 builds, nuggets that will stir you up to do everything God's called you to do in the kingdom. God bless you. Have a great day.